When it comes to overspending, we're very quick to identify the problem. My credit card bill is way too high. Oh my goodness, that receipt was a lot higher than I anticipated. And we're really quick to go for the solution, which is stop spending money. But we all know it's not as easy as just completely restricting ourselves from spending money. Oftentimes we are overlooking the cause to our problem. So instead of jumping from problem to solution, let's take a look at the root of the problem, which is the cause, which can help us achieve better, more relevant solutions to help us ease us out of overspending and finally get back into a place of feeling in control. All right, so the first example, we're going to take a look at a couple examples today, and we are going to look at this in a problem cause solution format. And I've actually been working on this activity through my certification with the Step Into Your Moxie Vocal Empowerment System. It is such a cool tool that I want you to get into the habit of figuring out exactly what are my problems with overspending. So let's take a look at the first example. Problem: I'm overspending on Amazon purchases. Now, what could the cause be with overspending on Amazon? A potential cause is I have the Amazon app located on the home page of my phone. So as soon as I open up my phone, I see it right there on my screensaver, and it's very easy for me to open up the app because I can visually see it and start shopping. The solution to this problem is moving the app icon to the second or third page of my phone's screensaver. Therefore, it's visually out of sight and I'm less tempted to spend money on Amazon. You could take this one step further and completely delete the app from your phone. Let's take a look at a second example. Problem: my Target bill is way too high. What's the cause of this problem of Target being really, really expensive for me? Well, I'm doing my grocery shopping at Target, and also because I'm at Target doing grocery shopping, I start perusing things in makeup, home decor, and clothing. The solution is to not completely rid of myself of Target, but rather do my grocery shopping exclusively at grocery stores, which would eliminate the impulsivity that I feel when I want to peruse through makeup, home decor, and clothing. Now, fun story that I want to share with you, because the previous two examples are really actual examples from my own life. Now, one day, Kyle and I had an argument and I just needed to get out of the house and reset my energy. So where did I go? I ended up going to Target. Now, I did have a few things on my grocery list, and so I said, let me go to Target, I'll do that, and I'll also do some retail therapy. I've been working in personal finance for nearly a decade, and I still find that I have some trouble with spending on things that aren't really needed. And so Target was my go-to. I could quickly see that I was spending a ton of money in different areas, such as $70 in self-care and clothes, $47 in fancy toiletries and vitamins, and $60 in clothes for my daughter. If you have a toddler, then you completely understand how fun it is to go shopping for them, especially for their clothes. So I quickly racked up a very high bill, because not only were I paying for these expenses, I was also paying for my groceries. So what could I have done instead? What was the cause to this problem? The cause was I wanted to feel better because I was upset, because I had an argument with my partner and I wanted to make myself feel better. And I thought the quickest way to doing that was to peruse Target and go through with a shopping adventure. But in all reality, a solution to this, not only keeping the grocery shopping exclusively at a grocery store, but also using some contentment activities instead of shopping to make myself feel better. Contentment activities come from doing fun and free things that really reflect your core values. I really enjoy being outside and outdoors, so I easily could have taken a walk on the beach or gone for a hike, gone for a walk around my neighborhood, and kept my expenses literally at zero instead of really picking and choosing these things from Target that ultimately only kept me happy for maybe a day or two. And now I'm like, well, I bought that t-shirt. Do I love it? No. Do I like it? Yeah. But it really didn't solve any of that piece that I was really looking for. If this is you and you are wanting to come up with some ideas for fun and free activities, definitely check out my How to Control Your Spending workbook. The link is listed below for you to check out. It has over 50 pages of activities, trackers, and worksheets to help you with your overspending. Now let's get to this next problem cause solution that I think a lot of us are dealing with. Problem: when I want something, I want it right now, so I put it on a credit card. What could be the cause of this problem? The cause could be impulsivity and fear of missing out is clouding your judgment to make the right choice for your finances. The solution is to build a purchase goal directly into your budget. But better than that, I'm curious, what does joy look like for you? Knowing the answer to this question could really get you to the root cause of why you want to impulsively put purchases on your credit card, knowing that you don't have the funds to pay it off immediately. So I think this all actually goes back to some of the root causes of how you experienced money as a child. Oftentimes when we were told no a lot as a child, no, you can't have candy at the grocery store, no, we're not going to purchase those tickets to the game, no, you're not getting that Barbie doll, no, you're not signing up for baseball. When we are told no as a child, oftentimes we overcompensate as an adult by purchasing whatever we want, whenever we want, because we feel that as adults, we can tell ourselves yes more because we were told no so often as a kid. On the flip side of that, if you were constantly told yes as a child, as an adult, you may feel entitled that everything that you ask for should definitely be given to you, and that it is your divine right to have everything that you ever desire. Now, I definitely want you to have things that you desire, and I also know that there is value in understanding what it feels like to actually save up and be patient with ourselves so that we can actually purchase things with cash in our own time. So there's three different things when I think about overspending is one, how you experienced money as a child, whether you were told no often or yes often, there's gotta be a good balance in between. Also building in contentment activities that keeps you from overspending and building that into a weekly routine. One of my weekly contentment activities is to take a long hot bath and read a book while I'm doing it, no interruptions. This is a really great way for me to just kind of step back from social media and from my phone and just relax. And this really keeps me in a place of contentment instead of trying to search for happiness by purchasing things online. And lastly, I want you to think about overspending and especially spending on credit cards is turn a no into a not yet. So we're not completely depriving ourselves. If we say that we want the new PlayStation, we're not saying no, we're saying not yet. Because what we're doing is we're actually going to build up some financial responsibility by taking a look at the price of the PlayStation and then building that into our budget, actually saving for that each month. Think about it. Every time that you put something on a credit card and you're being charged interest, you're actually taking that PlayStation and you're paying more for it over time and you get to keep it immediately. The problem with that is you keep yourself stuck in the debt cycle. And the PlayStation isn't really filling you with that joy that connects back to your core values. It's a temporary fix, but we're not getting to that root cause of the problem of the overspending. So if you found these activities and some of the insights here in this video helpful, give this a big thumbs up. And don't forget to check out the How to Control Your Spending workbook, which is listed for sale using the link below. And if you're not part of the Debt-Free Millennials family, come on and join by hitting that red subscribe button. We are building a community of over 100,000 subscribers. So make sure you don't miss out on any of the content that helps you achieve financial confidence that leads to more fun and less payments.
Bye.